Lesson 16, Introduction to USGS Hydrolink Tool. This video provides basic information about the Hydrolink tool to get you up and running with the basic tool capabilities. See other videos and documentation for additional details and tips. To get started with the Hydrolink tool, referenced as HLT, go to maps.usgs.gov/Hydrolink in Chrome or Firefox and log in using your ArcGIS Online account. If a user does not already have an ArcGIS Online account, USGS staff can request an account. After signing in, any future services in your ArcGIS Online account will display in the HLT dashboard. Note that only data added by the tool will fully function in edit mode. Add your data by selecting Add Shapefile or Add CSV. The Add CSV option also handles Excel spreadsheets. Ensure your input data meet the outlined requirements. Specify a name for your data and the directory of your file. And click Upload button. In the dashboard, select Edit for the newly uploaded data. In edit mode, the view defaults to the extent of the data with a satellite base map. You will notice 8 fields showing in the table at the bottom of the screen. These fields were added to the data upon upload and will be populated with NHD reached identifiers and Hydrolink data as records are processed. Before hydrolinking your data, we recommend the following setup to help improve your experience. First, click on the options symbol in the upper right of the table and select Show Hide Columns. Check those fields that will help you identify with site locations. In this example, I will select Site ID and Stream Name. You also have the option to change the base map using Switch Base Map in the upper left of the map. The satellite imagery will help you identify with a site location, but sometimes having labels or topography as a base map will also be helpful. Select a point to process by clicking on a point in the map or by clicking on the row in the table. We recommend selecting points using the table to help in tracking progress. Notice the point corresponding to the selection is now highlighted. Zoom to the point using the mouse scroll wheel or the plus and minus buttons in the upper left of the map. As you zoom in, the edit mode will be enabled. Editor status is displayed below the map, and NHD layers will appear. You will see the NHD high resolution and NHD plus medium resolution layers in the map legend to the right. Ensure that the point is representative of your sample site and/or other type of feature to be linked by using the combination of your personal knowledge of the site description in the table, and the aerial imagery. Move the point to the correct location if needed by first clicking on the point. A hand appears allowing you to click and hold to drag the point to the correct location. Note, it is not always appropriate for the point to be overlaying the NHD layers. When it is appropriate to link a point to both versions of the NHD, click the Locate button on the right, then click near the high resolution line that represents the appropriate linkage. Squares appear in the NHD layers to visually represent the suggested linkages. Suggested latitude, longitude, reach codes, and measures are also displayed in the right in the selected point coordinates box. If needed, the linkage process can be repeated to adjust suggested values. If the medium resolution linkage needs to be adjusted, unselect the NHD plus high resolution, click Locate, and click near the correct location on the medium resolution line. Reselect the NHD plus high resolution to once again show both linkages. If there are no appropriate lines to link the point to in one or both of the NHD datasets, then select No Reach for this point. When the appropriate selections are made, click Update. At this time, the verified location and information about the linkage to NHD is written into the table below. After Update is selected, the tool advances to the next point in the table. When all records are linked, return to the dashboard using the button in the upper right. Export the updated data as a shapefile by clicking on Export. Your data can now be documented and released. We recommend making your data available in the National Hydrography Dataset Linked Data Registry, where other users and applications can find and use your newly hydrolinked data. For more information, contact Mike Tinker. Also, as you use the Hydrolink tool, if issues with the NHD high resolution are detected, please report them using the NHD markup application at edits.nationalmap.gov/markup-app. This concludes lesson 16.